Hey guys, it's Lauren, and today's video is going to be an updated shakes and warps tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to execute four of my absolute favorite shake and warp combinations, and I'm also going to show you how to save these shakes and warps as presets, and how to apply these presets to your clips so that you don't have to remake the shake every single time you want to use it. Let's get into it. So the first combination consists of a vertical shake and a squish warp, which you guys have been asking for ages. I personally like to do my vertical shakes in terms of transform, so make sure you have your motion blur enabled, and make sure it's also enabled on your clip. And for some extra smoothness, go up to composition settings, click on advanced, and make your shutter angle around 350. Also, make sure you have motion tile on your clip, make sure you've increased the output width and height, and most importantly, enable mirror edges. So primarily, click P on your keyboard to go to position, and at the very beginning of your clip, add your first keyframe. Keep these same values. Move your time indicator forward exactly 2 frames, and increase your second value by around 100. Now move your time indicator forward 7 frames and decrease your original value by 40. So since I started off with 540, I'm gonna bring it to 500. Bring your time indicator forward another 7 frames and now increase your original value by 20. Again, my original value is 540, so I'm going to do 560. Then just bring your time indicator to the end of your clip and bring this back to its original value. Now highlight your keyframes, right click on one of them, keyframe assistant, easy ease. Now hit R on your keyboard to go to rotation. At the very beginning of your clip, add your first keyframe and keep it at 0 degrees. Bring your time indicator forward 3 frames and make this +6. Then move your time indicator towards the middle of your clip and bring this to -2. And now bring your time indicator towards the end of your clip and bring this back to 0. And just like last time, easy ease your keyframes. And this is what it should look like. Now we're gonna do the squeeze. In effects and presets, look up warp and add that to your clip. Change the warp style from arc to squeeze. Then at the very beginning of your clip, add a keyframe for bend and make it 0. Bring your time indicator forward 2 frames and make the bend 25. Then bring your time indicator forward 7 frames and make the bend -10. Then bring your time indicator forward 6 frames and make the bend +5. Lastly, bring your time indicator forward 5 frames and bring the bend back to 0. And this is what it should look like. Now, keeping my vertical shake from before, we're going to do a scale distort warp. So hit S on your keyboard to go to scale. At the very beginning of your clip, add a keyframe, click on this little chain to separate the dimensions, and make this first value 80. Then move your time indicator forward 2 frames, and bring this first value to 130. Then bring your time indicator forward 7 frames, and bring this first value to 93. Move your time indicator forward another 7 frames and bring this value to 105. Lastly, bring your time indicator to the end of the clip and bring this first value back to 100. Now it should look like this. Now we're gonna move on to the horizontal shakes. So first we're gonna do a horizontal shake with a skew warp. I personally like to do my horizontal shakes using Blurmo Curves, which is a Sapphire plugin. Make sure you still have motion tile on your clip from before, and in effects and presets, look up Blurmo Curves. Add that to your clip. At the very beginning of the clip, add a keyframe for Shift X and keep it at 0. Then move your time indicator forward 1 frame and change this to 200. Then move your time indicator forward 7 frames and make this value -50. Move your time indicator forward another 7 frames and make this value +20. And lastly, bring your time indicator towards the end of the clip and bring this back to 0. Click U on your keyboard to see your keyframes and easy ease them. And this is what it should look like. Now in effects and presets, look up transform and add that to your clip. Caret down on your clip and caret down on effects. Just to clarify, we are not using this transform that contains position, scale, rotation values, etc. We're using the transform that's under effects. So caret down on that. At the very beginning of your clip, add a keyframe for skew and skew axis. Make the skew -35 and make your skew axis 120. Then drag your time indicator towards the end of the clip, add 2 more keyframes, and bring these values both back to 0. Easy ease your keyframes, and go to your graph editor. I'm going to adjust these in terms of speed graph, so if your graph doesn't look like mine, click here and click on edit speed graph. I'm just gonna push both of these to the left, but not all the way to the left. We want there to still be some sort of curve. Just follow my graph. And
and this is what it should look like.
Now these skew shakes are really cool because all you have to do is change one value and you don't even have to adjust your graph to have a completely different shake. So for example, if I change my skew to positive 35 instead of negative 35, I get something like this instead. For the last combination, I'm going to do a horizontal shake with turbulent displace. I'm just going to keep the horizontal shake from our last example, and in effects and presets, look up turbulent displace. Add that to your clip. At the very beginning, add a keyframe for amount, size, and offset. Make the amount 45, make the size 180, and then hold down on this little dot and drag it towards the bottom of the clip. Then hit O on your keyboard to go to the end of the clip, change your amount to 0, your size to 430, and then just drag this dot to the center of your clip. And it should look like this. Now I'm going to show you how to save any preset. So hit U on your keyboard to go to your keyframes. And first, I'm going to save the horizontal shake preset. So I'm going to highlight the keyframes that are a part of the horizontal shake, then go up to Animation and click on Save Animation Preset. Then just title your preset whatever you want it to say. I'm just going to call this Preset 1. And then click Save. Now I'm going to do the same thing for my turbulence keyframes. I'm going to highlight all the keyframes a part of the warp, go to Animation, Save Animation Preset, and I'm going to save this as Preset 2. Now as you can see, I have a completely different clip and I'm going to show you how to apply these presets. So in Effects and Presets, search for whatever you named your presets. I named mine Presets 1 and 2, so I'm just going to look up Preset. And as you can see, they show up right here. So first I'm going to add my horizontal shake, and then I'm going to add the turbulence. And as you can see, it was super simple. So now you can save all your shakes and warps and use them whenever you please. That's it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you found it helpful. Bye!